違うのよ。あの子たちはそのね、わかるでしょ。
I don't think I do, but it's nice to see that it's a lively school. I agree.
でしょ。とりあえず行きましょうか。中に。
Having apparently forgotten what she was planning to do with her outspread hands, she totters through the school gate. Oh, that transition screen was ugly. It was a checkerboard. Her office is positioned quite near the school building's front entrance. That's a really nice looking office. Like, holy shit. The furniture is nicely arranged, based around an old-fashioned desk and chair. In contrast to the of the building's external appearance, this room is a textbook example of the old-fashioned principal's office. It is. I sit on the genuine leather sofa that's one of the room's more prominent furnishings. After waiting for me to settle myself, she lowers herself into the seat across from me.
学園長の橘千鶴です。
Oh no.
ようこそ、美浜学園へ。
Her name's Tachibana. That's an automatic boner.
それとも、お久しぶりね、の方がいいかしら、あさみくん。
What?On a practical level, nice to meet you might be the better option.
そっか。そうね、確かに。
With a slight, amused smile, Principal Tachibana takes out a pamphlet.
まあ、あなたのことだからもう概要は知ってるとは思うけど、一応説明はしておくわ。
She flips past a couple pages of the brochure. I hadn't noticed, but her fingernails are lightly polished.
ここは学校法人榊学園の運営する私学の学園で、全国から選ばれた学生たちを集めて日々勉学に励んでいるの。榊学園の母体は関東一円に私鉄網を持つ東浜急行電鉄グループ。その資金力を持って最高の設備と教職員を揃えているわ。まず。
The principal's talk shifts to a more detailed matters.The East Beach Express is an enormous corporate group with its hands in real estate and large-scale retail, but its core business is the management of the rail line connecting Tokyo to Haneda Airport? The EBE's management is shouldered by the Sakaki family, and it seems plausible that the Sakaki Academy Corporation is almost administered by them directly.But that's only a guess based on circumstantial evidence. There's a lack of public information on the secretive corporation's activities. The very existence of this academy isn't well known. I didn't gain anything that could be called definitive proof from my investigation so far.
あなたは2年生として学園に入ってもらいます。早速明日のホームルームで転校のことをお知らせするから、それ以降は自由に振る舞って構わないわ。
Okay. Her fingers come to a stop, bringing her hands gently together. The principal raises her gaze from the pamphlet and meets my eyes.
どう?あなたのお望み通り。普通の学園生活を送るには最適の環境だと思うけど。
I have a few questions.
どうぞ。
First, today is a weekday, but there was barely anyone on the school grounds. What's going on?
少数精鋭なのよ。学生数はあなたを入れて6人だけなの。
What? Only six?
そうよ。
The elite few?
ええ。
That include our friends with the cicada just now?
もちろん。
Question 2. Where am I living from today on?
全寮制なの。後で学生寮の場所を案内します。そこからここに通ってちょうだい。
A dormitory, is it?
寮といっても十分な広さのある個室だから安心よ。
In that case, not a problem.
以上かしら。
Before we finish, one last thing.
はい、どうぞ。
For this last question only, I stare directly into her eyes. I need to confirm the principal's intentions in bringing me here. After all said and done, is this a normal school? principal closes her mouth. After a moment of silence, she opens it again. Yep. Yep. I don't know about that. A gentle smile. I'm convinced that she isn't lying to me to further some hidden self-interest. Really.
Because I don't buy it.
Oh, okay. Maybe I'm wrong. I was just going to say, you don't have a fucking huge school with a giant wall around it that only has 6 classmates, including me, so only 5 other people. Oh god, what did I do? The principal slowly stands up and walks to the window side. The athletic grounds are visible from the window. Like, look at that wall, man. Although resembling those of a normal school, the grounds are skirted by an improbable high wall. Improbably high wall. The mere handful of students, the bizarrely extravagant facilities, the on-campus dormitory, the high wall surrounding it all. They clearly indicate abnormality.
でもね、あなたも分かってると思うけど、あなた自身の境遇を考えると、ここしか条件に合うところがなかったのよ。
I guess you're right.
私はあくまでも、ここは普通の学園だとあなたに言います。
The principal turns to face me.
だからあなたも、ここで普通に過ごしてくれればいいわ。
Understood.
それじゃ、寮の方へ案内するわ。Yeah.
With a nod, I rise to my feet. On the grounds outside, a gust of salty sea air kicks up a cloud of sand.
ここが学生寮よ。
This is not the dorm.
管理室も含めると、
No, it's not.
部屋数は全部で11。
Fuck you, this is not the dorm. This is not a dorm. This is the nicest looking place I have ever seen in my entire life. Okay, I would never go to a dormitory or a school with a dormitory that does not have a toilet in the room or access to a private toilet. Well, because I'm just shocked that everybody has a toilet, like it's a normal, like it's not normal for everybody to have a toilet. Oh, the cicada pair from earlier don't seem to be around.
Ah, Suo-san to Iris-san のことね。二人ともまだ学園に残っているのかもね。小峰さんもいないようだし。
That Komina guy is a student here too?
その子に寮の案内を頼んでいたんだけど
Wait, I said guy.
姿が見えないから
Yeah, it says here. I asked her for help guiding you around the dormitory, but she doesn't seem to be around. Is that a typo, or is that just me not understanding that it was a female we're talking about? So you don't have a minute to grasp on the movements of the students. I see.
私はほら...
I'm merely the principal of this place, after all. And there's only 6 students, and I can't keep track of them. Okay, I'll leave it at that. Merely, is it?
ちょっと待ってね。部屋にいるのかもしれないから。
The principal walks toward the interior of the building. Left there by myself, I stare vacantly up at the ceiling. Soon, I've unconsciously fallen into my habit of counting the number of visible sprinklers and roughly estimating the scale of the building. What? Okay. Everybody's got the quirks. That's his superpower, counting sprinklers, and being able to determine how tall a building is. Calculating the time needed to gain control of the front entrance and asserting the location, or ascertaining, excuse me, the location of the emergency exits. Not that many support pillars, are there? Guess that's why the ceiling is a bit low. Okay, something just poked me. Having grown absorbed in analyzing the building, I don't even notice the tug at my sleeve. Oh no. Okay, we're just gonna have to take it slow from here on out because there are multiple things in this image that... Okay. Until the final excuse me of my... of many finally catches my ear. I drop my gaze in the direction of the voice and find a girl in housemaid clothes looking up at me. Not that she's a particular diminutive height, except in comparison to be taller male, like to be a taller male like me. Am I perhaps an intruder? No one's going to admit that they're an intruder if you ask them point blank. The maid nods several times, slowly closes her eyes, and begins to repeat my words. Flexible thinking isn't your strong suit, clearly. Well, I'm a dick. Like, who talks like this to people? No, never mind. So what does a maid with me want with me? This would be the second time today I've heard that pickup line. You're a lot tougher than you look, maid. Would you answer her fucking question? Oh, this is
coming.
At this point, having noticed our voices, the principal calls out to the girl. It seems this maid was Kamina all along. I'm Kazumi, or Kazami, or fuck, the long A. Yuji, good to meet you. I don't think you introduced yourself. And this time, it's nothing but the first name. I had this thought earlier with the two, with the other two, but you've certainly gathered some unique elites here. Which should mean that she's a student too?
Does
she? That's not really my point of confusion here. Our uniform creates certain preconceptions. For example, if I see a girl wearing bunny ears in a bar, I don't ask what she's done with her Bible. That's not an explanation.
I
see. Also, her name is now Sachi. Is this a mistake? Because we clearly only know her name is Kamine. Just pointing that out. I don't know if there's something I missed. I see. You're a devoted one. That fallen bunny girl sister could learn a thing or two from you. I wasn't really intending that to be a compliment, but there's no point in telling her that.
Oh
man, I'd be so embarrassed. No objections.
それじゃあ小峰さん、あとはお願いね。
わかりました。それではまず1階から案内していきますね。
Yeah, if you would. The maid slowly begins to walk, but quickly comes to a stop in front of the management room. Stop dead, she's staring at me with an expression that clearly indicates she has something to say. What's wrong? You need something?
あなたのことを何とお呼びしたらいいのか聞き忘れていました。
Oh. Come to think of it, you're right.
すみません。
Well, you can call me whatever you want. Limp Pickle works just fine.
それでしたら、ゆうくんと呼ばせていただいてもよろしいでしょうか?
We've gotten pretty familiar all of a sudden.
では、かざみさんというのはいかがでしょう?
Kazami? Sure, anyway, I'll call you Sachi.
Sachi?
Ah, okay, see? Would Sachiman be better? See, now we're learning about why her name is Sachi, or why we refer to her like that. I guess they just played it into the game a little bit too early.
Sachi で構いませんよ。
Her expression didn't change in the slightest, but her eyes at the moment she spoke, those words had a strange forcefulness. That's so. Alright, Sachi. Best regards and all that.
Hi.
Judging from her smile, it seems she doesn't dislike being called Sachi.
それでは早速なのですが、寮に入って最初に見えるこの部屋が、風見さんのお部屋になります。
Damn. First floor room, next to the entrance. What a shit room. Nameplate seems to say it's the management room, though.
学園長さんのお話では、風見さんには寮長を兼ねて、この部屋に住んでほしいとのことでしたけど。
Oh, dude!You know how sucky it would be to show up at a school for the first time and end up being the superintendent? To the dormitories? Good lord, the responsibility. In other words, she wants me to play the prison guard. Well, at the very least, 3 out of the 6 students living in this dorm are females. Really? Who are the other 3? It would probably be prudent to have a room as far as possible from theirs to avoid potential trouble. Mind if I take a look inside?
はい。これが部屋の鍵です。どうぞ。
What's it look like? Ooh! When I open the door with the key she hands me, a prominently placed set of kitchen and household goods catches my eye. This isn't bad looking. The bed is in a fucking awkward place, but it's not bad looking. The chair, the table that looks to be built into the wall looks really nice. The door, is that the entrance door or is that like a different, like the toilet door? I don't know. Because it's got a fucking huge window on it. I guess that's the thermostat over there. A nice window. First of all, I must say that beds that just sit out, for this has to be up against something. It needs to be up against something! For fuck's sake, it can't just be loosely sitting out here doing nothing! And right next to a fucking window? Who sleeps next to a window? You fucking idiots! Okay.They seem to be in a good shape, and I can confirm with a glance that the room itself will be a more than adequate living environment given my needs.
この寮のすべての部屋には火災報知器が一つと二つのスプリンクラーが設置されています。
Two sprinklers. Got it. She seems to have guessed my thoughts from the direction of my gaze.
そこは一畳半ほどのウォークインクローゼットになっていると聞いています。
So it's not the toilet.As a little test, I focus my eyes on a different point of interest, and she provides an explanation in the same way. Although she's a little off in some departments, she seems to be pretty sharp in other respects. I see. Looks like there won't be any problems. As I speak, I twist the faucet over the sink. Was someone using this room before I came?
え、少なくとも4ヶ月は誰も使っていなかったはずですが。
The water is pretty clear, considering.
まあ、建物自体は新しいですし。
Oh, because it's not clogged up with shit, I see.
風見さんがいらっしゃる前は、
この部屋
を倉庫代わりに使用することもあったので、その時に誰かが水道を使っていたのかもしれません。私も時々、お掃除の時にバケツの水を汲むために使っていましたから。
I see. I twist the faucet to stop the water, drop the luggage I've been carrying on the spot, and promptly leave the room.
それから玄関を入って正面のスペースはみんなの共有の場所になっています。
The standard student dorm community space, is it?
はい。マキちゃんやアマネさんなんかはよくここで過ごしていますよ。
That so. Although I haven't heard those names before, they must be other students.
それから、風見さんの部屋の隣はボイラー室。その正面が階段で、その奥には4つの部屋があって、階段の隣の3号室が私の部屋になります。
I'd heard there are 11 rooms in total. Any reason why you picked one on the first floor?
それは、私の名前がサチなので、サッちゃんなら3号室でしょ?と。
Huh? Oh, right. I get the idea.
ここが2階です。2階は基本的に部屋のみの構造となっていて、私以外の学生さんは全員この階に住んでいます。
I was gonna say, Sachi does not rhyme with three, but that's because I'm reading three in English and not in Japanese. Which would mean two of these are vacant.
はい。7号室と9号室は現在空き部屋になっています。3階はこの大浴場をはじめとした戦闘的な構造になっています。
Whoa, what?
階段の反対側にはコインランドリーや物干しスペースもあるので必要な時に利用してください。もし洗濯自体が苦手なようでしたら私に言っていただければ代行しますので。
Wouldn't taking care of someone else's chores be a nuisance?
クラス委員ですから。
All right, I'll keep that offer in mind.
はい。
But I would be extremely embarrassed to let you fondle my underwear. There's no reason to refuse outright when the offer is delivered with such an earnest smile. By the way, can we use this grand bathroom as we please?
はい。清掃は専門の業者さんが定期的にやってくれているので、清掃中以外は24時間利用可能です。ただ、男湯と女湯に分かれているわけではないので、風見さんが入浴する際は入り口にこの札をかけるようにしてください。
Okay, so how long before there's a whole bunch of people in here when we walk in? As she speaks, she hands me a card that reads In use, male bathing.Sure, I think I might take advantage of it pretty often. The view up here is pretty nice. It is. I mean, I fucking hate the ocean, but that's beautiful. Because there's whales.
そうですね。周りには校舎の他に高い建物もないですし、ガラスの透過率も 75% ですから、
What?
海面に沈む夕日を眺めることもできますよ。
What is a percentage transparent window? I mean, I guess the lower the transparency, the thicker the...Like, the harder it is to see through, but I've actually never heard of that until just now. Interesting. I just looked up at my window to see how much I could see. Mine's like 2% transparent because it's dirty as fuck from the outside weather. So, ugh. An ocean view, huh? Not bad.
ご希望ならすぐに入ることもできますけど。
As she speaks, I notice Sachi's already holding a towel and change of clothes in her hand.You're pretty well prepared.
この大浴場を見た大体の人はすぐに入ってみたくなるみたいなので。
I see. The fruit of your experience, is it? Oh shit. Roll the credits half. What's wrong?
風見さんのための着替えではなく、私の着替えを持ってきてしまいました。
Well, there's nothing wrong with that. I mean, I'm not wearing them, but...As if to demonstrate, female underwear slips out from among the clothes in Sachi's hand. Oh no. Is this a declaration that you want to bathe together?
いえ、そのつもりはありませんでした。すみません。
I really don't think there's anything to apologize for.
ありがとうございます。では、これで寮の案内は終わりになりますが、何か質問はありますか?
Let's see. Can I ask about something other than the dorm?
私に答えられることでしたら。
In that case, let's hear your three sizes, Sachi.
はい。 上から82、56、83です。
Why? At that moment, is there a specific man you're going out with?
いません。
Your experience with men to date?
ありません。
I know I'm the one who asked you those questions, but answering them so politely, would that also be because you're the class representative?
クラス委員はみんなの役に立ってこそのクラス委員ですから。
What an admirable devotion to customer service.
ありがとうございます。他に質問はありますか?
Nothing's come to mind.
わかりました。もし他に聞きたいことができたら、部屋にある内線電話で3番を押してください。私の部屋につながるので。
Got it.
それでは、私はこれで失礼しますね。
With that note of farewell, Sachi bows like a genuine housemaid and starts to turn away. Ah, Sachi!
Hi.
Thanks for the tour. I appreciate it. Wow! Suddenly I'm not a dick! What the fuck happened? It's like a turn of- it's like a whole new person. Class representatives these days seem to be surprisingly tough-willed breed. I almost said bread. After Sachi's tour ended, I took another look around the interior of the building on my own. Oh, now that's pretty. By the time I return to my room, the sun is already low in the sky and the light growing dim. Should probably put this stuff away before it gets dark. Opening my backpack, I pull out the contents and begin to put them away on the shelves I've been provided with. It's a real help that I've got a closet. Things I can leave in a visible place, and things can be stowed away in the back. Dividing my possessions between the two, the latter are clearly more numerous. Normal, huh? While looking over my mountain of luggage, I mutter in a self-deprecated tone, and realize that there is nothing normal about this school at all, and any sane person would realize this. As I work, the sun sinks leisurely into the sea. Ooh, now that's beautiful. That transition was nice. School gate. Guess this is like chapter 2. At my usual time, 4:45 a.m., I woke up in my usual way and ran the course I've marked down mentally on my way here. Oh, he goes out for a morning jog. To tell the truth, when I was stopped by the policeman yesterday, it was because I'd been wandering back and forth in the same place. Ah. I'd been planning out a possible marathon route, in other words. Okay. I woke at the usual time, ran at the usual time, and now I'm eating my usual breakfast menu. No different from the days when I was living together with my master in the mountains, my standard tempo of living. Master, I guess it was his, oh for fuck's sake, what he was talking about earlier. If there is a difference, it's limited to the slight surprise I felt when I opened my eyes and found a roof over my head. During my hike from, oh no, Yamanashi, I'd gotten used to sleeping in the open, so, wait, what was the cutoff? So when I woke up inside a room, there was a slight feeling of unease as I thought, right, I'm living in a dorm now. That mild discomfort hasn't disappeared even now as I'm eating my corn cereal. Ugh. It's hard to settle down inside a new layer until it's ingrained with your scent. Good lord. Even so, I'll start living at this tempo every day from now on, going to school every morning, so there's no real need to rush things. If I actively spend every day packing myself with potentially useful knowledge, someday this sort of lifestyle might come naturally to me. The effort strikes me as a little troublesome, but as my master once told me, when it comes to your life and your women, a little bit of trouble is just about right. Speaking of women, they're a simple bunch, but that doesn't make them any less difficult to handle. I learned that much in my first year living with my master. In my master's words, when you're a brat, running fast is enough to make you popular. When you're a middle schooler, the guys who can fight will be popular, and after that, it's the guys with brains who get the girls. Yeah, I don't know about that. In other words, run, punch, and read books, and you'll never run dry. What do you think? Short and sweet, right? That was her theory, at least. The things she said were always ridiculously simplistic. Honestly, I ignored those words with a snort the first time I heard them, but my master was a woman who put her beliefs into practice. Every morning she made me run, and every day she hit me with a stack of books. Although I don't know if she's to blame, I still run 16 kilometers every morning and habitually read books whenever I have free time. Sometimes she was harsh, sometimes she was sweet. She would emit an abrasive, overpowering aura at times, but every once in a while she could be so gentle that I thought my brain would melt out my ears. That was my master, a woman with a sizable build who was nonetheless very picky about the little things. I've had a hard time dealing with large women ever since those days, but being aware of that fact doesn't mean I can fix it. It's not that I dislike them on a conscious level, but whenever I see a tall woman, I can't help but feel wary of the pure instinct. If you ask why I'm bringing this up all of a sudden, well, that would be because I've just been reminded that there's a large woman at this school as well. Who? Oh my goodness, that voice is adorable. Oh, look at this! Since this place is a student dormitory, it's of course only natural that a community of students would already be living here, you know, a community of five other students. And it's entirely probable that they all have their own rules that I don't know yet. Also, I'm a country hick fresh from the rural areas of Yamanashi, so it goes without saying I'm poorly versed in the customs and rituals of this land. I have no way of penetrating the depths of significance that might be hiding in an action that thought, the action that at a glance looks to be a simple case of bullying. What game's this? What are the rules? Oh, for fuck's sake. That is the, what? Oh, for fuck's sake, man. Don't make me sound like an idiot. The puzzled faces staring back at me are familiar. It's the little girl and big woman combo I arbitrarily nicknamed the Cicada Sisters when I first arrived at the school yesterday. Hold on, I dropped my fucking cap on the floor. Ow!
Dare?
Who do you think?
質問に質問を返すのはバカの証拠だって誰かが言ってたよね。And
so, I suppose that means I am irredeemably stupid. Please call me Moron Boy, as if we've been friends for 10 years, Cicada Sisters.
セミ姉妹?
I saw the pair of you from the gate yesterday. One of you was swinging a cicada around, and the other was shrieking, if I remember correctly. I'll see what I can do. Nah, I'm not forgetting about that.
ねえ、もしかして今日転入してくる学生って君?
Yeah. Kazame Yuji. Good to meet you. I thrust out my right hand, but the tall woman in front of me doesn't show any sign of grasping it. She stiffened on the spot, staring fixedly at my face. It looks as though she's even forgotten to breathe. That's an important thing to do. You don't want to forget about that. Something wrong? The big woman's frozen expression suddenly melts, and she lightly shakes my hand. It's an unexpectedly small, but decidedly cold hand.
Kazami Yuji? Yuji-kun ka. Naruhodo ne. Watashi wa Suo Amane. Hajimemashite, Yuji-kun. Hora, Makina. Anta mo jikoshoukai wa?
Makina? Oh no, you don't want to use no Makina. That's... Yevon don't like that. Yevon don't swing that way. Oh. Sorry, that was a...
Why do I...
Oh, no.
Makina. Iris Makina.
Aww. Irisu Makina. Or Iris Makina. Eris is a Greek god, and is it machina, a Latin word? Oh, fuck, it is. It totally is. God damn it, I thought maybe it was just spelt... literally translated, it would be something like Mecha Rainbow Goddess. Okay. What country are you from?
Oh.
I see.